Don't you feel that that's precisely why people tend to question surveys in general? Because there are the scientific ones that hew to how it's supposed to be done, and there are those that tend to favor certain candidates.
I'll tell you the leading hypothesis, all right? Because I don't know what's in the mind of the people who sue us. I'm not going to pretend I know. But the leading hypothesis in the books, abroad and everything, as to why politicians don't like them, is because the surveys affect their donors and their volunteers. You know, it squeezes the money flow. It makes the volunteers decide, maybe I won't work so hard. It hurts the morale, and that's the real effect, not the effect on the voters, but the effect on their resources and their volunteers.
All right, attorney, if you could respond.
Well, first, with respect to saying that their surveys are scientific, they're not. The fact that in the past, in 2004 and 2007, their surveys, the prediction of their surveys were wrong. Like in 2004, 2004 during the presidential elections of GMA and FPJ, they predicted that GMA would win in the NCR. And when in fact, what happened in the re-election was that, you know, FPJ won in all the cities in NCR except for Las Piñas, with a marginal advantage of only 1,800 votes. And the same thing happened with Senator Trillanes and against Ralph Recto. They said that Ralph Recto would be a sure winner, placing number 6, and Trillanes was way below, and that there's no chance for him to win. And what happened was the complete opposite. Trillanes was ranked, I think, number 7, and Ralph Recto did not make it. But these survey companies have not apologized. They have not explained why their surveys turned out that way, and they have not mended their ways, and they do not
We don't even have ways to mend. Actually.
They do not even publish these methodologies, which is required by law.
They're published.
They're not being published.
They're
in the surveys.
Published. You look at our website properly, and it's being said.
But that
over
is something
and over
that will
again.
Be litigated, sir.
Yes, go ahead. Go ahead and okay. Let me say, you know, that in all parts of the world, you know, these one or two cases where the surveys didn't predict are always being used, you know, as evidence, you know, that they don't work, you see. Okay, so it's not 100% flat. It's maybe only 95. In fact, we're only using 95% error, you see. So up to now, we can cite the errors, quote. We can cite 1948 in the United States, 2004 in the United States, 1992 in England, 1995 in Germany. You can count them on your hands, you see. And okay, it was wrong in NCR in particular in 2004 in the exit poll here by ABS-CBN. In fact, we were surprised there, and we had it studied by an independent group. And then the report of the independent group was also published in our website. I don't know if you've seen that, you know, because we were worried that it was sabotage, right? Mm-hmm. And it came out, no, it's not sabotage, it's probably due to the sampling error. And sampling error is sampling error, you know, that's the most scientific thing you have there, you see. So if you're going to expect 100%, and because of that, you'll say, you know, therefore they're wrong. Sometimes they will be wrong. Sometimes they will be wrong.
Can you elaborate on...
You can't use that as a basis for saying that we're always wrong or stop operation, because you're trying to use that to prevent freedom of speech, and that's terrible.
Elaborate on that, Dr. Mangahas? What exactly was the sampling error about? Because this is really bruited about all the time, the error in NCR. Was it because there was there was a delay in those who went home after the polls.
The sample wasn't big enough. Wasn't as big as we expected it to be. Right. We wanted it to be double, you know. It was only about less than 600, I believe, and we wanted 1,000. But we had to stop early because of our deadline here. Sorry, ABS-CBN, we were wanted to do that. And we should have waited longer. That's the lesson that we had there. So do it again better, you see. But it's, you know, there's a complain as you like. You can't use 1948 and 2004 in the United States to prevent polls from being done. That's foolishness, you know. That's like saying you should stop a hospital from operating, you know, just because mistakes are made once in a while, you know.
All right, Mon Casiple, Dr. Mangahas mentioned the effect really on the candidates of the polls, of funding being withdrawn or not forthcoming because of the surveys. Would you confirm this?
Yes, that is usually the effect. Mm-hmm. It's not on the voters, it's on the candidates themselves, on the morale of their staff, on the financiers, on their allies, because usually a survey is commissioned by a candidate to know where he stands at one particular moment. It's also being used by those in his camp. The voters is too broad a group to have an organized response to a survey. In fact, that's where the business comes in, when candidates, of course, commission surveys. But beyond that, I don't think surveys would make that kind of an impact, a huge impact, on the decisions of an individual voter.
All right, Ricky, I do understand you want to bring in some comments from our Twitter friends.
Yes, we've asked our viewers to tweet us their comments and their questions. We've got a few. And again, these are comments from people on Twitter, from Maya P. Ching. Survey results should not be shown to the public for us to vote who we think is right, not just because he's winning. In other words, we should not be allowed to be influenced by surveys. I think that's in agreement with to some extent, with Attorney Diaz's arguments tonight, that it has an influence. Anyway, there are other comments here. Most people have said that I've heard a lot of people will decide to vote for one or the other so that the other won't win, the other way around. So, again, a diversity.
The underdog effect.
Yeah, a diversity of opinions coming out here about our topic for tonight.
So in closing, briefly, gentlemen, let's start with Attorney Diaz, Dr. Mangahas, and Mon Casiple. Your parting shots, Attorney Diaz.
Yes. What we are saying is that
briefly,
these surveys are a form of freedom of expression, but freedom of expression is not absolute and it's not without limits, especially when it transgresses on other people's rights. And in this case, it has transgressed our client's right. Our client's political and the citizen is his citizen right, his right to a fair and free election, which is not biased, and he's accorded equal treatment with other candidates.
Dr. Mangahas.
We don't want people actually to change their votes on account of the surveys, because then the surveys are not going to predict properly. Just listen to them, ignore them, and vote the way you like, and that's the best way for the surveys to succeed. Right? Now, as for rights, freedom of speech is a preferred right. You cannot say that another right is more important than freedom of speech. You cannot put prior restraint on freedom of speech because somebody else's welfare is going to be affected. Freedom of speech is preferred.
Mon Casiple.
Well, I would say bring it on. I mean, we don't have to be afraid of surveys. Only the losers are afraid of it. The winners would approve of it.
All right. And on that note, we close our discussion. Thank you very much, Mr. Mon Casiple, Dr. Mangahas, and Attorney Diaz for joining us.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You know, the thing about it is that, as I said in Twitter, if your survey numbers are good, it's the surveys are your best friend. If your survey numbers are poor, they're your worst enemy. You've seen how the opinions of the candidates have changed, whether or not, depending on whether or not their survey numbers are up or down. Noynoy Aquino, when his numbers were up, was not questioning the surveys. At that time when his numbers came down.
No, he said some surveys can be bought in Quiapo.
After his numbers came down.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
And now that his numbers are up, you don't hear him complaining anymore.
Former
President Joseph Estrada, always a believer in surveys until his numbers went down.
What's up next?
More surveys.
This one from the Makati Business Club when the rundown returns.